A woman might say, one day, I'm going to blank my husband.
Divorce?
Divorce. Hey, Cindy. A woman might say, one day, I'm going to blank my husband.
One day, I'm going to kill my husband.
Don't kill him, yeah. Chuck, one day I'm gonna blank my husband.
Cook him his favorite meal.
One day I'm gonna cook him his favorite meal, my husband. Hey, Chuck, this is fill in the blank, not fill in the storyline. It's a blank. It's fill in the blank, not make up a damn story. Hey, Mike. One day, I'm gonna blank my husband.
I'm gonna love him.
Love him.
Oh, good answer.
We got two strikes now. We're going too fast. Jen, you gotta save the day or the Bradford family can steal. Ooh. One day, I'm gonna blank my husband.
Have children with my husband.
You know, Jen, I gave you this big speech. Told everybody how good a player you were. Told us, I even said she don't miss. Well, it's a new day. One day I'm gonna have children with my husband.
Oh,
God says so. A woman might say, one day I'm going to blank my husband.
We're gonna go with slap, Steve.
Slap. Number six.
Boy.
One day. Five.
Hello.
Four.
Surprise.
Top eight answers on the board. If a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive? Darren.
Steve Harvey.
Oh, I know I ain't gonna be number one. But I just wanted to soak in that moment. Thank you, sir. Steve Harvey! Go play, man. Talk to you. Oh, no. Are we playing? Oh, no. Pass or play?
We're going to pass.
Pass.
Oh, they're passing.
Yeah.
Rochelle, if a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive?
It's a little bit of a throwback, but I'm going with Eddie Murphy.
Eddie Murphy! If a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive?
Jerry Seinfeld.
Jerry Seinfeld, baby. My man. One of the best. Wow. Carol, a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive?
Chris Rock.
Chris Rock, my man. The Rock. Mike, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. The Goalie family, they can steal. Mike, if a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive?
I would say Sinbad.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good answer.
Sinbad.
Oh.
Wow. Here we go. Miss Shirley, if a good sense of humor is a turn on, what comedian is the sexiest man alive?
How about Jimmy Fallon?
That's my man. Jimmy Fallon! Number seven. He's a funny man. Six. 5.
Dave Chappelle.
All day. 4.
Stephen Colbert.
3. Top 7 answers on the board. Every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal? Nadine.
A lizard.
Lizard.
Man. Steve Harvey's.
Pass the play. We're gonna play. Let's go. Seth, yes, every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
I'm thinking dog.
Dog?
Yeah, I'm saying dog.
Dog! Yeah. Hey, Jamie, every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
Lion.
Lion. Christopher, every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
A giraffe, Steve.
A giraffe! Yeah! J.O., every kiss seemed like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
Like a snake.
Like a snake! Ray Dean, every kiss seemed like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
Like a camel.
Like a camel! Every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
I think anteater.
Anteater! Yeah! Jamie, you can clear the board. One answer left, only one strike. Every kiss would seem like a French kiss if you had a tongue like what animal?
I'm gonna say bear.
Yeah!
Like a bear!
Let's go, John!
Christopher. Yeah. This time you have 2 strikes, your Jad family can steal.
A cow, Steve.
Yeah. A tongue like a cow! All right, guys, top 7 answers on the board. Listen to me closely. Name an animal starting with S that a wife might say her husband reminds...
A snake.
A snake!
Play, Steve.
Laura?
Yes, sir.
Name an animal starting with S that a wife might say her husband reminds her of in bed.
Oh. What about a sloth, Steve?
A sloth! Well, teacher of the year, this should be right up your alley. Name an animal starting with S.
Skunk.
Skunk. Gabby, name an animal starting with S. Wife thinks her husband reminds
Ooh,
her.
Steve, I'm gonna say a sloth. Oh, well, you said sloth.
Ileana, name an animal starting with S that a wife might say her husband reminds her of in bed.
A shark.
Shark.
Yeah.
Name an animal starting with S that a wife might say her husband reminds her of in bed.
A seagull.
A seagull. All right, we got 2 strikes, Laura. Levandusky family can steal. Name an animal starting with S, a wife says her husband reminds her.
What about a snail, Steve?
Snail!
Yeah.
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 All right, family, here's your chance now. Name an animal starting with S that a wife might say her husband reminds her of in bed.
Squirrel.
Squirrel! number seven. Top five answers on the board. Name something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in his spaceship. Seth.
Toothbrush.
Toothbrush.
His helmet.
His helmet.
We don't play Steve.
Sharique, name something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in the spaceship.
His space suit.
Yes! Good answer. Good answer, Paul. Good answer.
Sorry.
It's a good answer. It's a good, strong answer, Steve.
You like that answer?
I mean, yes.
How strongly do you feel about it?
It's gonna be at least number five.
I'm gonna go out on a limb.
He says number four.
I think it's number four. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay.
If it ain't number... Oh, shut up, Steve.
All right, Sharique. Name something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in his spaceship.
His food, Steve.
Yeah.
His
food. Yeah.
Hey, Risha.
Yes.
Name something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in his spaceship.
His oxygen.
Yeah. His oxygen. Yeah. Nicole, name something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in his spaceship.
How about the navigation system?
The navigation system.
Let's go. We need it. We need that.
Hey, Grady, something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in the spaceship.
How about fuel, Steve?
Yeah.
Fuel.
Yeah.
Dina, one answer left. You can clear the board. Something an astronaut would hate to discover they forgot to put in the spaceship.
I'm gonna say a toilet.
For him to go to the bathroom. He gotta go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Toilet.
Look at me,
sir. Top eight answers on the board. Here we go. Name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of. Tiffany.
Your mouth.
Your mouth.
We're going to play.
TG?
Yes?
Name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of.
My ear.
Your ear. Joshua, name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of.
My nose.
My nose. Miss Tony, name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of.
The rectum.
Taylor?
Yes.
Name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of.
My lady parts at the OBGYN.
I was trying.
The lady part! Tiffany, name a part of your body. We have no strikes.
Yeah.
Name a part of your body a doctor might look inside of.
My eye.
Your eye.
All right.
Name a part of your body that a doctor might look inside of.
Your...
Joshua, only one strike. Name a part of your body that a doctor might look inside of.
Your arm.
Look inside your arm. You a frog at the biology class.
Come on, stop.
Well, now we're down to two strikes now, Miss Tony. We got to be careful. The Gibbs family can still give me a part of your body that a doctor might look inside of.
The navel.
Look inside your navel. Okay. Name a part of your body that a doctor might look inside of.
Your penis?
Look inside your penis. Number 8. 6.
Hey.
Top 4 answers on the board. Give me a word that rhymes with tube. Crystal.
Boob.
Boo. Justin, give me a word that rhymes with tube.
Cube.
Cube.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chelsea, give me a word that rhymes with tube.
Lube.
Yes. Lube. Jared, give me a word that rhymes with tube.
I'm gonna go with tube, Steve.
All right, my man. Sound just like it to me. That's a 100% guarantee that it's gonna rhyme. If you say the exact same damn word, it ain't nowhere in the hell it don't rhyme. Tube. Lisa, give me a word that rhymes with tube.
Pube, Steve.
Pube. Sydney, one answer left. But this time you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and win the game.
I'm gonna go with noob.
Noob!
Yeah, yeah. That's a good answer.
All right, family. All right, family, one answer left. You give me that answer, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if that answer's not there, the other family gets a chance to play sudden death. Here we go. Give me a word that rhymes with tube.
Scoop.
Okay. Say it like you mean it.
Scoob.
Yes, that's up there. Scoob.
Scoob. Scoob. Four. All right, guys, top 7 answers on the board. Fill in the blank. Well, blank my buns. Henry.
Slap my buns.
Slap my buns.
Kiss.
Kiss my buns.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Crystal, well, blank my buns.
Rub.
Rub.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Christian, only one strike. Well, blank my buns.
Lick.
Lick. Miss Michelle, only one strike. Well, blank my buns.
Toast my buns.
Toast my buns. All right, Chris, just fill in the blank. Blank my buns.
Kick my bun.
Kick it, kick my bun. All right, now we got two strikes. You got to be careful. The other family can steal, Henry. Well, blank my buns.
Not me, but feel my buns.
Feel my buns. All right, shoot the girl, fill in the blank. Well, blank my buns.
We're going to say butter. My buns.
All right, guys, top seven answers on the board. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows. Carrie.
He lies.
He lies. Leo.
Yes, sir.
Name something a cheating husband does the moment he realizes his wife knows.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Gets rid of the evidence.
Good answer, good answer.
Oh. Hey, man, we got one strike. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He cries.
Yeah. He cries. Hey, Irene, tell me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He buys her something?
He bought, come on. He buys her something. Big Nate, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Moves out.
I just caught you cheating. Moves out. Carrie, name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
Maybe apologize.
Apologize. It's going pretty good. Leo, wow. My man. Here we go. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He tells the truth about it.
Yeah.
You gotta just tell the truth sometimes, you know? And it sets you free.
What's up there, Steve? The truth will set you free.
He don't cheat, so he gotta tell the truth.
Don't even work in court, partner. Listen to me. There's a couple things you're gonna need to understand about cheating. Once you tell the lie, you must ride the lie all the way out. Tells truth about it. All right, we got two strikes. Salvo, we got to be careful. The Russell family can steal. Okay. Give me something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
A divorce.
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 Divorce. Okay, family. Name something a cheating husband does the minute he realizes his wife knows.
He goes and gets drunk.
He goes and gets drunk. Number seven. Four. Top seven answers on the board. Name someone famous whose booty seems to have its own publicist.
Kim Kardashian.
Kim Kardashian.
Let's play.
Okay, all right, let's play.
We're gonna play. Miss Robin, how are you?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Well, we good. Let's play.
Okay.
Name someone famous whose booty seems to have its own publicist.
Nicki Minaj.
Oh, yeah.
Good answer. Let's go. Let's go. Yeah.
Yeah. Nicki Minaj! Jake, Mr. West Point. Name someone whose famous booty seems to have its own publicist.
Steve, I'm getting a little excited. Queen B, Beyonce. Let's go now. Come on.
The Come Queen, on. Beyonce.
Let's go.
Bailey, name someone famous whose booty seems to have its own publicist.
I'm going to go with Cardi B.
Yes. Cardi B. This the one I want to hear, though. Yeah. Hey, John, name someone famous whose booty seems to have his own publicist.
J-Lo, Jennifer Lopez. Yeah. There you go.
There you go. Yeah. J-Lo! Allie, somebody famous whose booty seems to have his own publicist.
Amber Rose.
Oh. Amber Rose. Miss Robin, God, I'm gonna love this one. Somebody famous whose booty has his own publicist.
Baby Rexha.
Baby Rexha.
BB Rexha. Jake, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Kaiser family can steal.
I know she's maybe a little top heavy, but Pamela Anderson.
Thank you. Kind of gave it away in your explanation. Pamela Anderson. Name someone famous whose booty seems to have its own publicist.
Megan Thee Stallion.
Megan Thee Stallion. Number six. Number five. Top seven answers on the board, fellas. Here we go. What might Grandma do if she found another granny's panties in Grandpa's car? Brennan?
Scream.
Scream.
I'm gonna go with take his dentures.
Take his dentures.
We're gonna play.
Donnie?
Yes, sir.
What might Grandma do if she found some granny panties in Grandpa's car?
I'm thinking pure shock factor. She's probably gonna die.
She's probably gonna die. Keel over and die. Hey, Jamal, Grandma do if she found some granny panties in Grandpa's car?
Hit him.
Hit him. My favorite guy, Charles. Look here, man. What might Grandma do if she found granny panties in Grandpa's car?
She gonna find some grandpa panties somewhere.
Did I read it wrong? I see where you're going with this, Charles. I see where you're going with this. Go find some grandpa pants in the car down there that was inside the gas station when it. Oh, man. Hey, we got two strikes this time. You gotta be careful. What might Grandma do if she found another granny's panties in Grandpa's car?
Put him out.
Put him out. Brennan, two strikes, other family can steal. What might grandma do if she found another granny's panties in grandpa's car?
Call a friend and complain?
Call up a friend and complain. What might grandma do if she found another granny's panties in grandpa's car?
Take his retirement.
Take his retirement. Number 7.
Destroy car.
6.
Wash and fold up.
She don't know whose they are. I like these here. Number 5.
Laugh, be glad.
3.
Kill, run over him.
Top 7 answers on the board. Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance. Odise.
Shave.
Shave.
More often.
Jamil, how you doing, man?
I'm great. How are you, Mr. Harvey?
Welcome back. Welcome back.
Thank you very much.
Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
I'm gonna go with exercise.
Exercise! That'll get it, John. Lose 200.
It's a big boy.
Yeah, she should have been had this conversation. Zuka.
Yes.
Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
His clothes. Change the way he gets.
Changed his clothes!
Good job.
Ely, how you doing, man?
I'm good, Mr. Harvey. How are you doing?
Good, man. All right, Ely. Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
I'm gonna say to tan. Get some color.
Tan! Diana.
Yes, sir.
Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
Well, you know, your wife can't suggest this to you, but I would say haircut. It's up there.
I like the haircut.
Good answer, good answer.
It's up
there. Haircut! Odise, name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance. Jamil, two strikes. My D.O. family can steal. Give me something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
Get some jewelry.
Get some jewelry. Get some jewelry. Name something a woman might suggest her husband do to improve his appearance.
Improve his hygiene. Take a bath.
Take a bath! Number 7.
Face transplant.
Wow. Wow.
Whoa.
The whole thing, ladies? Number 6.
Grow beard.
All right, let's go. Top 6 answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, what's the sexiest thing your wife has?
Yeah. Her lingerie.
Her lingerie.
Her body.
Her body.
We're white.
Thank you. Hey, Dan, how you doing?
Very good.
Welcome back, sir. Talk to 100 married men. Chris is right next to you. Yeah, this ought to be good. What is the sexiest thing your wife has?
Oh, I would say her eyes.
Boy, you better come on, Dan. Boy, that's a hell. Demise Boy, yeah. Miss Chris, that had to make you feel absolutely wonderful.
It does.
Talk to 100 married men. What's the sexiest thing your wife has?
Some toys.
Good answer. That's a good answer.
That was hard to say.
Yeah, they want you to be more specific.
I can't.
She said, I can't. She said, I can't. I was just joking, they don't rule. Toys!
Good answer, good answer.
Babe, you the youngest son?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
You all right?
Yep.
Okay, good. No, that was just your mama's answer would have threw me into therapy. I'd have to ask 100 married men, what's the sexiest thing your wife has, David?
Her personality.
Her personality. Two strikes, we gotta be careful now, Kate. 100 married men, what's the sexiest thing your wife has?
Her husband.
Yeah. We asked 100 married men, what's the sexiest thing your wife got? Me. Me. Yeah. Beth, Fauntleroy family Castile, what's the sexiest thing your wife has?
Her scent.
Her what?
Her fragrance, her scent.
Oh, her scent.
Yeah.
The scent of a woman. We ask 100 married men, what's the sexiest thing your wife has?
Her love making.
Her love making. Number six.
Smart.
Three. Ladies, top eight answers on the board. We asked 100 married women to fill in the blank. Admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
A woman.
A woman.
Was Steve Harvey.
Was Steve Harvey. Oh. Matt.
Sexy.
Sexy. Jamil.
Buff.
Buff.
Play.
Pass or play.
We'll play.
We'll play.
Hi, Monica.
Hi.
Talk to 100 married women, fill in the blank, admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Wealthy.
Wealthy.
Great answer.
Hey, Brad, admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Well, I'm hoping not, but dead?
Dead. Oh, that's gonna be up there. You ask 100 women that question, trust me. Six of them said dead. Dead! Lori? Hi, Happy.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Fill in the blank, admit it. Sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Smarter.
That's a good answer.
Smarter. Less of a moron.
Sad.
You can remain a moron, just be less. Talk to 100 married women, fill in the blank, admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
More romantic.
More romantic. Matt, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Famous.
Famous. Monica, admit it. Sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
A better cook.
Oh, a better
great
cook.
Answer. Great answer.
All right, we got two strikes, Brad. Khalil family can steal. Admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Your husband was a football player.
What's your husband? What's a football player? We asked 100 married women to fill in the blank. Admit it, sometimes you wish your husband was blank.
Funny.
Funny.
Good answer. Good answer.
Number five.
Young 195.
Wow.
Whoa.
Two.
Over.
Derek. Name something that has white balls. Derek.
Ping pong.
Ping pong. One answer.
Yeah. Golf.
Golf. Pass or play?
We're gonna pass, Steve.
We're gonna pass. Boy, y'all do that a lot. They're gonna pass.
All right.
Hey, Michelle.
Hello, Steve.
How you doing?
I'm doing very well.
So how's it been married to this soldier for 21 years?
It's been absolutely fabulous, Steve.
All right, Michelle, let's go. Name something that has white balls.
I would say softball.
Softball. Yeah! Kim, how you doing?
Wonderful. Good. How are you, Steve?
All right, Kim, name something that has white balls.
Cotton. Cotton balls. Woo!
Cotton. All right, big fella, name something that has white balls.
I'm gonna say polo.
Polo.
That's right, polo.
Polo. Polo. Mel, how you doing, darling?
Great, how are you?
Good. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
You got two strikes, you gotta be careful. Finch family can steal. Name something that has white balls.
Foosball.
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 Finch family, here we go. Taffy.
Volleyball.
All right, here's your chance, ladies. Name something that has white balls.
Volleyball.
I don't know. Volleyball. Number seven.
Pool table.
Six.
White goose.
That's the worst answer we've ever flipped over, man. I was thinking it, but I was hoping it wasn't up there. Number five. Name an occupation in which you'd find a lot of neurotic people. Sonia.
Striptease dancer.
Striptease dancer.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, well, let's see. Striptease dancers. Jennifer?
Porn star?
A porn star. What's happening here? A porno star? Really? Really? A porn star is an actor. Have you ever seen a porno flick before? It's the worst acting people on the planet. They're not. Congratulations. Play or pass?
Pass.
They're gonna pass it.
Thank you.
Thank you. You started it.
No.
Talking about the strippers. Go over there and play. Ladies, top four answers on the board. Here we go. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's. Cherie.
The chest.
Yes. Yeah.
Good answer.
The chest.
Play. Steve, we're gonna play.
Oh, they're gonna play. Yeah. I'm excited. Let's get to this one right away. I can't wait to hear these answers. Cindy. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man.
Her badonkadonk derriere, her butt.
You scared me for a minute. I didn't know where you was going with this. Her badonkadonk, I was going, oh, God. I don't know. Okay. The padonkadonk, the thing. Yes. 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 This is my favorite question on the Feud ever. Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's, Tiffany.
How about her hips?
Yes, they are.
Yes, yes, they are.
Lord, them hips. Yes. Yes, I love all these answers. These are my favorite answers.
Yes, yes, yes.
Aunt Gwen?
Okay.
Name a part of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man.
How about her thighs?
Her thighs. Yes. Yeah. Oh. Another favorite body part of mine. Her thighs. Good answer. That's okay. Let's go down here. Oh, this is so much.
Yes.
This is the best game show in the world. Name a part, Stephanie, of a woman's body that's usually larger than a man's.
Let's try her stomach.
Well,
when she's knocked up, it's larger than a man's.
Oh, okay, cause okay.
Right, well, let's do that.
Okay, well, you know.
Let's put it up there, Steve. Hey, number four answer, Steve. Okay.
Right now, you're killing my buzz. I was floating along real nice here. Her stomach. Sheree, you got two strikes there. If it's there, you clear the board. If it's not there, the Carnett's family gets a chance to steal.
Her lips.
Yeah.
Woo! Take it, Joseph.
Let me tell you right now, I have yet to run up into that situation. You got lips bigger than these. This is going to be a disaster. You know, there is such a thing as too much kissing. I almost killed a woman one time, smothered the girl half to death. Those lips! Ladies, here we go. Name a part of a woman's body is usually larger than a man's.
Her brain.
Yeah. You know what'll really tick me off?
If it's up there,
yeah, that's true. And I can't say nothing about it either, brother. I've seen it work out that way. Help us all, Father. The brain! Tell me a word a married man would use to fill in the blank. I would blank for sex. James.
Pay.
That is a sad, sad very statement
very sad.
About married men.
Completely agree.
So completely true. Bethany?
Cook. Clean.
I would lie for sex.
Yes. That's a guy answer. You don't know how deep this runs with us. You would lie. Yes, lie.
I've never done this, but beg.
Yes!
I would never do that. Don't have to!
Yes.
Don't have to!
Yes! Beg! This is a guy question. They don't even know.
I guess not.
Two strikes. No chance you can blow this, James.
I'm gonna kick it up a notch and say, kill.
Yes. Boulay family, get ready to steal.
Now, this isn't me. I would cry for sex.
Baby, did you let the two women down there influence your answer? Yes, you did. Why would you do that? This is a guy question. Want some big dude laying on her crying. Number four. Die. We'll buy it. We'll kill you about it. We'll beg you for it. We'll lie about it. And at the end of the day, We'll lay down our life for it. Name a business that might be very busy on Valentine's Day. Kiki.
Florist. He didn't hit it, did he? You gotta hit the buzzer.
What the hell? Come on, Steve.
Name something people hope of.
That they go to heaven.
That they go to heaven. Wait till you hear the rest of this question. Look at me.
Okay.
Name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed. Debbie?
Pee.
Wow. Pee!
They're gonna play.
Hey, they're gonna play.
It's a long walk, Steve.
Yeah, it is.
It's a long walk.
Oh, God, look who I'm talking to. Oh, this ought to be good right here. Name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed, Andrew.
Steve, I had to quit inviting people to my house because they wouldn't stop masturbating.
I told you at the beginning of the show that it was just of my opinion that your son was involved in drugs. Where we at now? Okay, kind of feeling me a little bit now, Miss Lynn?
Yes, sir.
Doing the nasty thing in the bedroom. It's a form of it. It's just you're alone.
I only invited one person.
I know, Andrew. Just shut up. I know. Miss Lynn, name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Get sick in the bed, like throw up.
Get sick in the bed. Get sick in the bed. Only one strike. Donna, name something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Well, I'll say cutting their toenails.
Oh, good answer.
I agree.
Yeah.
Cutting their toenails. Two strikes, Whitney. You saved the day before, though.
Eat in the bed.
Okay. Hope they don't eat in the bed. Eat in the bed. Yeah. Whitney, you keep pulling them out. She's a good player. Two strikes there, Debbie.
Their pet in the bed.
Great answer.
Especially her pet. Keep the pet out of the bed.
Jump in the bed.
Joyce, give me something people hope a house guest doesn't do in the bed.
Jump in the bed.
Hope they don't jump in the
jump
bed.
In the bed. Good answer.
Jump in the bed. Number four. Point values have doubled. Here we go. Top six answers are on the board. Name something that follows the word pork.
Lawn.
Huh?
Lawn. Pork lawn. L-I-O-N. Lawn.
Oh.
Pork lawn.
Glad you spelled it, because I'm... The hell is a pork lawn? I thought you said lawn like the grass outside. I was going, what the hell is a pork lawn? Lawn! Looking for the pork loin. Yeah. Joe?
Pork belly.
Pork belly.
We're gonna play! We're gonna play!
We're gonna play.
We're
gonna play.
Yes! Oh, Lord.
What am?
Name something that follows the word pork.
You pine.
Huh?
Huh? You pine.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes. Respect it.
Yes, lunatic.
What? He said, cupine. Cupine. What? What is cupine? This is the greatest answer I've ever heard. No, I feel you.
Number one.
I feel you. It's number one.
Oh, my mom.
Pow. It's number one. Oh, really? Well, I tell you what, it's gonna be number one on YouTube, but it ain't gonna be number one on that. I bet every dollar I got. You the only person that said cupine. Cupid! Point values are double. We got top seven answers on the board. Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Darcy.
A gerbil. No. I've heard about something like that once.
Yes, 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 you said it. You said it. Let me just write out like that.
That's awesome.
First thing you can come up with, just bam, gerbil. Just like that. First answer. Oh, no pressure. Bam, gerbil. Just like that. Pull it out. I've heard of this. Hey, hey, over here, over here. Gerbil. Gerbil, gerbil, gerbil. Chubble, 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 chubble. Name something a doctor might pull out of a person. Bam! Gerbil! Gerbil! Man.
A baby. A baby?
A baby!
You want to play, Steve?
I don't care. Kendra, name something a doctor. We are not changing the game because a bunch of famous people is here.
That's a good one.
Oh, baby.
So stupid.
Oh. Come on, Jesse. You got this.
I got y'all. I got y'all.
Name something. Y'all can't talk amongst each other.
They ain't saying nothing to me. They was talking to themselves. I got my answer in here. I've been thinking about this. Okay.
Y'all not coming back. Name something. I don't have this trouble with regular families. They be starstruck, glad to see me. They in their own damn world over here. They're talking to each other, sharing. That's a good answer. You ain't supposed to say that. Jesse, name something people pick out ahead of time so they feel them be nice. You got two strikes. You got to be careful. Pack a team can steal.
The pastor. Number one! It's the number one!
That's it.
It's got...
You need all that stuff for a funeral, Steve.
You do. You need the... You gotta know
who the hell picks out the pastor.
I would.
A good pastor, you want him to sit down.
You gotta... You know, the
Don't
pastor
cry.
Or the priest. They
He's
gotta...
going to him.
Come on.
Right. Come on now. He got the suit on. I'm picking DC to be
laid down.
Woo.
He's with Jesus.
Hey. Oh, yeah.
Shall I say it again?
One more time.
One more time.
Oh. He's laid down. He's with Jesus.
Come on now.
Stop your crying.
Yeah. You better preach. You better preach. That's good, man. That's good. That's better than that damn answer. Pick out a pastor that might die before you do. Folks, here we go. We got the top seven answers on the board. Name something you put in your mouth but don't swallow. Amanda.
Gum?
Gum.
We're gonna play safe.
They gonna play. Yeah. Megan, tell me something you put in your mouth but you don't swallow. Wow. You ever walked up to somebody and saw the look on their face and you just know? I walked up to her and I went, whoa. I mean, man, you talk about the cat that ate the canary look. Megan, I'm gonna ask you this question. I want you to think about this show and all the years it's aired, how many families have enjoyed this wonderful form of Christian entertainment. So find a way to give me your answer and keep it where we can all be working when you're done.
Well, I'm a pastor's wife, but I will say this out loud, they're sperm. You know it's up there, Steve. Everyone knew it. It's up there. We're going for the money.
We're going for the money, so that makes it all right. It doesn't matter that I'm a pastor's wife. Ticket to hell is worth $20,000. You know it's up there, Steve. No, I don't know a damn thing is up there. What you ain't gonna do is drag me into your little nasty world. I don't know nothing is up there. Oh, Steve, you know what's up there. Oh, hell, I know what's up there. I have kids. Now. Yes, yes, yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It ain't up there, yeah. Now, it ain't up there, yeah. Hey, it ain't up there, yes. Yes, we can all still probably go to heaven. All right. Hey, 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 uh-huh, uh-huh. And what you get for saying it? You're gonna stay on the air. Family Feud, 20 more years. Richard Dawson, we love you, man.
Hey, I would
if
say...
If it's there, you win, Lacey. Name
a
something.
A hot guy.
You'd be next to a hot guy.
Yeah. Or a hot person.
Or a hot person. This is good.
I love hot chocolate, by the way.
You like hot chocolate?
Yes.
I like marshmallows in my hot chocolate. Can't play with me. This is what I do. God, I'm not going to have a marriage. I love my wife so dearly. Here we go. We're looking for a hot thing next to you sitting boiling. Here we go. Name something a woman does for her baby that she... Yes.
Changes his diaper.
Changes his diaper. Name something a woman does for her baby that she also does for her hubby. So your big nasty man just laying his little nasty self up there, just boo-booing on his big old funky tail, huh? Change his diaper. Something a burglar would not want to see when he breaks into a house. Rob.
Naked grandma.
Naked, huh?
I don't want to see that either.
I know you're right, okay? Nobody wants to see a naked grandma, but what are the chances God, he's breaking in the house and running up into your grandmama naked. Looking for a naked grandmama in the house, outside, in the woods, on the blanket. That's the occupant person that's there. All right, guys, here we go. We got the top six answers on the board. Name something that gets passed around. Chris.
A joint.
A joint.
Can I leave?
Yeah. Yeah. Now, Chris, I don't know what 100 people you thought we were talking to at some nice little mall across good old America, but I'm pretty sure the people didn't tell the survey people, hey, an illegal drug. Let's turn around and see how many weed heads are out there with Chris. A joint! This is when you know we're going to hell. Okay, Tracy, only four answers topic, so.
The collection played at church.
Now she's got the halo, you know, and I got the horns.
I like the way you tried to stop us from going to hell. You, Mr. You Evil Boy, passing around the little thing with this funny smell. Looking for some saving here. Church plate. Oh. It's less than the joint. This is not good. I'm just gonna do, you just go over there. They're gonna play this.
Yes, we are.
On the board. We asked 100 married men, which of the seven dwarfs describes your wife in bed? Terry!
This is just to get up on the boards. Bashful?
Bashful. Bashful! Two answers topic, Michael. You control it.
We're playing.
They're gonna play it. Yeah. All right.
Come on, you got it.
There's a guy over there that this meant nothing to him. Hey, listen, point values are doubled on this one right here, so this could get you right back in it. We surveyed 100 people. We got the top six answers on the board. Try to get the most popular answer. You ready? Here we go. Name a celebrity who has a big mouth and is not afraid to use it. Daryl.
Steve Harvey.
I had to go there.
Okay. All right. Let's see if it's up there. Steve Harvey. Laura.
He just retired, but Larry King?
Larry King? Larry King! Oh, fuck. I got it. The hell was I thinking? Oh. I like these razor-sharp questions you guys got. This is That's how you keep that show moving. Just keep coming up with what you think is a good-ass question.
You guys can head back.
Yeah. Hopefully.
Oh, yeah, I'm gonna be good at this show by tomorrow. Name a celebrity with a big mouth who's not afraid to use it. Steve Harvey. When he did it, I just wanted to go, And if it had really been up there, I'd have really been pissed. I'd have went, this is so rigged. I don't even want to read this before. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay. Okay. I ought to just do it like this. Just give me two people. Let's go. I mean, hell, I ain't gonna do nothing but go back anyway. What's up? Give me Laura, give me Daryl. Let's play Feud. Larry, talk to 100 men. Name the first part of a woman you touch to get her in the mood. Let's quit playing, Larry.
Let's play.
That would be the lower front or the vagina.
I didn't want to say it.
You ain't want to say it?
Well,
you know what's happening on that. You know, good hair, well, that ought to be number one. He said the lower front. Yeah, down there on the prairie. Down there by Homeland Security. Down there by the promised land. Down there, where the deer and the antelope play. Home, home, home on the range. Land of the free. Home of the brave. Down there in the lower front. The 40 acres and a mule. Down front. How the hell that ain't up there? You see the smile on these men facing it? I don't want to host this show no more. Let's go meet the Walton family.
Hey, John, how you doing, man? What's going on? What's going on?
Man, good-looking young dude right here,
That's
man.
That's right, yes, sir.
How old are you, John?
I'm 21.
Yeah, yeah. What do you do, John?
I'm actually a senior at University of Illinois, and I also am on scholarship there, too.
So what's your major?
So I'm a pre-med honor student, actually.
Pre-med honor student.
Steve, I'd like to be an orthopedic doctor.
Orthopedic doctor.
Orthopedic doctor. I also play hockey at the university.
Where?
Steve.
Yeah.
I also won Citizen of the Year real recently. The Citizen of the Year Award.
You say one more damn thing, and you gonna marry my daughter. You say one more damn thing. Boy, what a great day to be a host of Family Feud. All right, now, guys, top seven answers on the board. We asked 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Joseph. Shopping.
Yeah, she is. Yeah. Shopping. L'Oreal, we ask 100 women, if you were Mrs. Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
I would be doing the nasty with Steve.
I don't give a damn if that ain't up there. Best answer I've ever heard in 13 years. Do the nasty with Steve Harvey. Oh. Gemma, talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Tuning in, watching Family Feud.
Tuning in, watching Family Feud. Miss Loria, talk to 100 women. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
At the spa.
At the spa.
Good answer.
That's a good answer. Now, Sterling, you gotta be careful. We got 2 strikes. The Sonya family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Traveling.
Yes. Traveling. Joseph, we got 2 strikes. You gotta be careful. Other family can steal. If you were Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Planning dinner.
Marjorie, need to be in the house cooking me some damn dinner. We asked 100 women, you and Miss Steve Harvey, what would you be doing right now?
Counting my money.
Number 6. Yes. Send that to the house. 5.
Divorcing him.
Nah. Number 3. Top 8 answers on the board, ladies. We asked 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed. Angela.
A police officer.
Oh.
Cindy.
A dancer.
We ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A yoga instructor.
Yoga instructor. Hey, Mike, 100 women, an occupation a man has makes him good in bed.
Bodybuilder.
Yeah.
A bodybuilder. Jen, we ask 100 women, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
No explanation with this one.
No, you just did it.
Okay, well then, he's got a pole, he's got a hose, a fireman!
He got a pole, he got a hose, fireman! Hey, Lori, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, so I think maybe because he knows about lady parts, a gynecologist?
Gynecologist. Cindy, name an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
Construction worker.
A construction worker. Chuck, only 1 strike. You'll put a stop to that. Name an occupation that a man has that makes him good in bed.
Okay, Steve, what about a plumber?
This boy right here is just for my entertainment. I love you, dude.
Yes.
Plumber! I ain't mad at you. Mike? Two strikes. The other family can steal. Give me an occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
A farmer.
Y'all messing with me now. You know, good with them hoes, you know what I'm saying?
That's where the saying came from, farmers are good in bed.
Farmer!
Come on!
Talk to 100 women, name and occupation a man has that makes him good in bed.
I'm gonna go with musician.
A musician, yeah. Number seven. Six. Well, let's go meet them, everybody. It's the Dowdy family. Hold on one second.
Okay. Okay,
Steve. Ooh. Oh. Come on, brother.
What's up, boy? Good. T.
Get the feel, boy. Come here to you, man. Get a word, man.
What's up? Woo! Look at the deal. Woo! Yeah. Woo! I've been friends with that dude for 61 years. Oh. Surprise. Grew up next door to me. Wow. Been in Cleveland 61 years. Wow. Should've told me you was coming, man. I feel like crying seeing your punk ass. Top four answers on the board. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties. Michelle.
Silk.
Silk! You better come on, Michelle. Michelle, congratulations. That's how you play relax. Chris, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
I'm gonna go with cotton, Steve.
Chris, you my man, boy. Oh, got your dad down there?
Father-in-law.
He done a hell of a job doing it.
Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Now, let me ask you a question here. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Lace, Steve.
Come on, boy. Lace! Crystal?
Crystal.
Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Polyester.
Polyester. Now, let me something. I want to be clear. I don't know the rest of these answers. But cotton and polyester? Christian, if you give me this answer, we're still alive. We got two strikes, though. You gotta be careful. The other family can steal and win the game. Christian, name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
Spandex.
Spandex! Family, I got two answers. You give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family wins the game. But if it's not there, the Smoke family is going to win the game. I need an answer. Name a sexy material used to make sexy panties.
We're gonna go with latex.
Great answer.
This is for the win. Latex! Number four, I don't know.
Candy tried.
Oh my God.
Three. Top five answers on the board. Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
Sporting event.
Sporting event.
Strip club.
Strip club.
We're gonna play.
All right, great. Hey, Eva, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say a bar.
At the bar.
Good answer.
Hello, Bria.
Hey.
Name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
Maybe picking up some drugs, Steve?
Good answer.
I'm picking up some drugs. I was... Tess, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
His side chick's house.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Over the side chick's house. Tony, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up there.
I'm gonna say casino.
At the casino. Yeah. One answer left. We can clear the board. Kevin, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say over at his friend's house.
Over at his friend's house. That was a good answer. Two strikes, you gotta be careful now, Eva. Davis family can steal or you can clear the board. Name a place a man has a good time till his wife shows up.
I'm gonna say at work.
Okay.
At work. All right, family, name a place a man has a good time until his wife shows up.
At a bachelor party.
At the bachelor party. Top four answers on the board. Name something Abraham Lincoln probably used to ride on. Delaney.
A horse.
A horse. Megan, something Abe Lincoln used to ride on.
A carriage.
A carriage. Eric. Tell me something that you know for a fact. Abraham Lincoln used to ride on.
Maybe a donkey.
The last time you saw somebody come riding in on a donkey. The donkey! Bridget, only one strike. Name something Abraham Lincoln probably used to ride on.
I don't think they had the bicycle back then, but maybe, maybe.
Good answer.
Possible?
A bicycle. Alan, we got two strikes. We got to be careful. If it's there, we're still alive, sir. But if it's not there, the other family can steal and win.
The train.
The train! Delaney, we have one answer left. Delaney, if you give me that answer, your family wins the game. But this time you have two strikes. If it's not there, the other family can steal and they will win the game. Name something Abraham Lincoln probably used to ride on.
Miss Lincoln.
The nicest squares families I've ever met. All of a sudden, game four. Riding in on donkeys. And now he's riding Miss Lincoln. Oh my God! Riding on that thing Miss Lincoln got! Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Dowdy Girls won the game. And now it's time to play. All right, you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
My mother-in-law.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Temperature.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
The seatbelt.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
5 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coca-Cola.
Let's play!
Okay.
Let's go!
Name someone in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said... mother-in-law. Survey said... fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank. You said... temperature. Survey said... name a safety device on a roller coaster. You said... seatbelt. Survey said... what time does a gym rat work out in the morning? You said... 5 a.m. Survey said... name a brand of cola. You said... Coca-Cola. Survey said...
Hi, Steve.
You nervous?
A little bit, yes, but I'm gonna be okay.
I don't know how to tell you this.
Break it to me fast. Break it to me fast.
You don't like all this waiting
around?
No,
just don't even, just cut
you
out.
You wanna hear about
it? Let me hear.
You need 2 points.
Oh,
Let me be a little bit clearer.
I'm sorry.
You need 2 damn points.
Okay. Yes. Okay. I forgot. What else to do?
2.
Okay.
You ready?
Ready.
Let's put that 198 points up on the board, all the answers, please. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Amy, name someone in your life who you wish would take a vow of silence.
Husband.
Fill in the blank. Your doctor takes your blank.
Blood pressure.
Name a safety device on a roller coaster.
Seatbelt.
Try again.
Safety harness.
What time does a gym rat work out in the morning?
Oh, 5 a.m.
Try again.
6 a.m.
Name a brand of cola.
Coke.
Try again. I sure hope you get this 2 points. You need 2 points, $20,000. Somebody in your life you wish would take a vow of silence. You said... Survey said... Number one answer. All of them. Whatever she said, that was the number one answer. She got all number one. Top four answers on the board. Here we go. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Set.
Can I change it?
I like the way Lori said, set.
Cut.
Cut!
Good play, Steve.
Oh, I got you. All right, Danielle. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Action.
Action. Cindy, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
I'm going to say lights.
Lights! Alex, give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Take one.
Take one! Michael, we got 2 strikes. If it's there, we're still alive. If it's not there, the other team can steal, and they get to play sudden death.
How about break?
Break!
Good answer. Yeah. Good answer.
Oh. All right, I got 2 answers on the board, family. Here's the situation for you. If you give me either one of those answers, your family steals, your family gets to play sudden death. Woo. But if it's not there, Morrison family, flat out, they win the game.
Yeah.
So we need this one. Give me a word you might hear a director shout on a movie set.
Quiet.
Good answer.
Quiet. Quiet on the set. Number 4. Yeah. Top 7 answers on the board. Name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Beyonce.
You better know it. Greatest living performer today, Beyonce knows.
Cardi B.
Cardi B.
We're playing, Steve.
Beyonce's number 4. Wow. It's gonna be interesting. Michael, name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
Diana Ross.
Diana Ross. She does, though. Michelle, name a female singer who can bring down the house when she performs live.
J-Lo.
J-Lo. Name a female singer, bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Mariah Carey.
Mariah Carey. Come on. Let's think this out, man. Let's get some points on this board. We got two strikes, Dirt Family can steal. Mia look pretty confident. Female singer, bring the house down.
I'm gonna say Ariana Grande.
Ariana Grande. Name a female singer who can bring the house down when she performs live.
We're gonna go with Shakira. Woo! Yeah.
Woo! Shakira. Number 7. That's a true statement. 6.
Rainbow McIntyre.
5. Top 6 answers on the board. Name the sport that most resembles your lovemaking style. Brittany.
Football.
Football, wow. Great thing. Football. Kapoor.
Wrestling.
Damn. Wrestling.
Let's play.
Steve, we're gonna play.
Yes, well, we're in it. Sonny?
All right, I'm gonna go with baseball.
Okay.
Nice and long.
Baseball! Good answer for this. Name the sport that most resembles your lovemaking style.
Well, see, since I play volleyball, I'm gonna say volleyball.
Yeah. Volleyball! Oh! Ani, we got two strikes. You gotta be careful. The other family can steal. Name the sport that most resembles your lovemaking style.
Swimming.
Swimming! Name the sport that most resembles your love-making style.
We're gonna go with gymnastics.
Gymnastics! Number 6.
Horse racing!
Wow.
Number 5.
Oh, wow.
Number 4.
Golf.
Number 2.
Tennis.
Top 8 answers on the board. Name someone famous who wore a robe. Lisa.
Jesus.
Jesus wore a robe. Yes, he did.
The Pope.
The Pope. Wow.
Play.
We're going to
play,
Steve. Okay, good. We're going to play. Come on, let's go. Hey, Allie, name someone famous who wore a robe.
I'm going to go with Mother Teresa.
Good answer, Allie.
Mother Teresa. Mike, name someone famous who wore a robe.
Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Who did you say?
Obi-Wan Kenobi, Star Wars. Oh.
You're letting your nerves.
What? You ain't know who Nobi Dobi Dobi is? Dobi Dobi Dobi! Will, we got two strikes. Come on, man. Name somebody famous in war robe.
Steve, I'm gonna have to go with Hugh Hefner.
Good answer.
I ain't mad at you. Hugh Hefner.
Yeah.
You know we're all going to hell, don't you? Hugh Hefner is above Jesus. I want to stop playing right now. I don't feel comfortable where we're going with this. Danny, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. Vega family can steal. Name someone famous who wore a robe.
Steve, we're going to go with Julius Caesar.
Ooh. Julius Caesar! Lisa, we got two strikes. We're trying to make a comeback, though. Vega family can steal.
Queen Elizabeth.
The Queen Elizabeth.
Oh.
All right, family, give me somebody famous who wore a robe.
You know what it is?
Gandhi.
Gandhi. Gandhi. Seven.
Ruth Bader Ginsburg.
Five.
Muhammad Ali.
Four.
Judge Judy.
Well, Yancey family, they got 130. Top eight answers on the board. What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about him?
His bald head.
I don't know her. I do not. Bald head.
I'm gonna say your mustache.
Yeah, mustache.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play.
Come on, Steve Harvey. Right here, baby, right here.
Of all of the questions for this side to have.
That's right, Steve. Yeah. 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 Accident, baby, accident. Come on, Steve.
What do you think? Oh.
We got, can't hear you, Steve.
I said, what do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about him?
Those lips, Steve.
It's so cool.
Yeah. Go on with the Wheel of Joy now, Steve.
Come on over here. The teenage version.
Come on. Get right here. Stay right here.
You know what? I've never been, like, embarrassed. But, like, right now, I'm actually nervous.
And you should be.
I know what you're saying.
It's all right. It's all right.
All right, Wheel of Joy.
Mm-hmm. What's the question again?
I'm going to read it to you. What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about him?
I'm going to say his money.
Oh!
If you can't be cute, be rich.
Oh!
Money!
Yeah! Bay is ballin'! Bay is ballin', yeah,
yeah.
That's
so bad. All right. Hey, y'all ain't got no damn strikes. Be over here for a while.
We can go on all night long. We'll
be back next
question. We're gonna see you in Baltimore on Sunday.
Thank you. ever felt somebody staring at
yeah,
you?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, they breathing behind me and everything. They just going. Miss Donna.
Yes, sir.
What do you think, Steve Harvey's wife?
I think it's those gorgeous dimples, Steve.
You know, okay, you.
The dimples. The dimples.
What it is, sir?
The dimples. Go ahead, Steve.
Come on, God, just help me out. Dimples! What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about it?
Your personality?
My personality! Up here, these is kids. Down there, that's death row. Bring your ass down here. What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about him?
The way he dresses.
The way he dresses.
I got a nice, right. Quiet.
What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best
all
thing
them about jobs
him?
You got, baby?
All them jobs!
Benefit.
I've got two strikes the Bennett family can steal. What do you think Steve Harvey's wife would say is the best thing about it?
I know this is a PG show.
Uh-oh. Give it to him! Give it to him!
But I'm going to say you probably lay that thing down and...
That's not.
It's not up there, though, is it?
That ain't gonna
I mean,
be
up not there. Yet. Come on, go look up there and see if it's up there. See if it's up there.
It ain't up there.
Oh, but I know it's true, though. It ain't gotta be up there on that board.
Come on, buddy. What do you think Steve Harvey's wife says is the best thing about him?
I think we're gonna go with your eyes, right?
Yeah.
Your eyes.
Yeah. Be up there. It's up there. It's up there.
Be up there. Eyes.
Be up there.
I'm so glad this over. Number eight. All right, guys, let's go. We've doubled the point values here. Top seven answers on the board. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing. Jeff.
Sister. She's never gonna forgive me for this either.
No, she's not.
Lindsay, you're not the sister.
No.
Where's your sister right now, Joe?
Probably hiding somewhere.
Is she in the building?
Or hunting for a weapon.
They got a new device now. It's called YouTube. You're gonna be a major star, Joe.
I'm sure.
Yep. Big Jeff. His sister. Yeah. Well, you got seven other people gonna be in the same room in hell with you. 20.
A pillow.
A pillow? Yeah. Wow. Oh, pillow. Oh, okay. They're going to play. Yeah. Hey, Jeff. Hang in there, man. That was a good answer. I've never heard that. I didn't know that. It's really smart. Heidi, when you were a kid, name something you used as a partner for practicing kissing.
Use your hand.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was so somewhere else. Use your hand. Ooh. Mackenzie, let's go. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
I'm gonna say a stuffed animal.
A stuffed animal. This is actually fascinating to me. Because I don't know any of this. The pillow really threw me off. And it was number one. So, hey, Taffy, let's go.
I'm gonna go with another neighbor kid.
One of the neighbors. Come here, boy. Ramsey, let's go. Only one strike. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
A doll?
Here we go, man.
A doll! You guys are rolling. 20, it all started with you and the pillow.
Sounds a little strange, but how about the mirror?
Good answer.
The mirror!
Man. You see how we're pregnant?
Y'all was having a good time. No wonder y'all pregnant. Y'all just so good and tried everything. Been all in the mirror down there with the little girl down next door. You got a baby doll in your hand. Come here, give me that animal right here. You just been in the house practicing. Woo. I bet y'all stuffed animals is laying on the bed like, yeah. Oh, yeah. I got to be the luckiest bear in the world. Because you're all attractive girls. I'm sitting at y'all's house going, what a life. Hey, Steve, what are you? I'm a stuffed animal. Don't you wish you were something else? Uh-uh. They'll be home in a minute. What y'all working on today? We doing pregnancy today. You only got one strike, but you only got one answer left. When you were a kid, name something you used as a partner to practice kissing.
We're gonna say a sucker.
Good answer. Good answer.
This explains it. You know this explains it, don't you? Y'all got all the answers. If that's on the board, I will. A sucker! Two strikes, McKins. Got to be careful. Pippin family can steal. Yeah, go on, say it. I want to hear this.
Orange.
An orange. What were y'all doing at your house? You got a pillow? You got this poor baby doll need therapy? You in the mirror? You using your hands? And that stuffed animal is waiting on y'all to put all that mess down. I'm ready. Come on, baby. Let's do it. And orange. Point values are triple. We got the top four answers on the board, ladies. Here we go. Tell me another way people say mother.
Mama.
Mama.
Mommy.
Mommy.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Play. Yes. Slant. Oh, Yolanda. Yolanda, tell me another way people say mother.
Nanny.
Nanny! Yes. Cecilia, name another way people say mother.
How about Nana?
Nana. Folks, you got two strikes. If it's there, you're still alive. But this time, if it's not there, the Kamenzin family can steal and win the game. Sheila, tell me another way people say mother.
What about Steve Nene?
Yeah, you say it.
What Nana?
Didn't you say Nana?
I did say that, Steve, yes.
Nana.
Uh-huh.
And I said Nana.
Well, what is you saying? Stop clapping. What, is you trying to say it in Spanish or something?
Steve.
It's the same word.
It's the same word,
they're gonna
okay.
spell it the same way, E-N-A-N-A. You just can't go changing the inflection. And no, can't okay. be your answer. So I'm just, before you say no. Okay, Sheila, tell me another way people say mother.
What about mommy?
Okay. Oh, mommy.
Right.
Not mommy. You want
mommy.
Right. Not mommy.
Right.
Oh.
Got me?
I see you. I feel you. That's hot. Okay, now, let me ask y'all something. Y'all crazy. That y'all can take all these words that's the same and just say them different because you want to? Nanny? Nana? Nani? No? Okay, we gotta go again. Okay, tell me another way people say mother.
What about mommy? Well, we already said, mommy.
Yeah, because look at me. Y'all stop laughing at this. Listen to me. See, watch how I do this. Mommy. See that? Mommy. Now watch this here. Mommy. Okay, well, hold up. Okay, now watch this one. Mommy! Here go another one. Mommy! Oh, mommy! Mommy! Get it out. Hey, y'all had time to think of something about now.
Right. Okay.
Now, tell me another way people say mother.
Okay, Steve. Nana.
This shit can't be happening. Listen to me. I get paid to host a show. Did too much shit here. And to the kids up there, listen to me. We ain't gonna add this like this, cause you'll never be able to survive this up at the school. We're gonna cut this down to one, maybe two nanas. Two nanas and two mommies. We're gonna cut this back. Cause this here. Okay, Steve. I got this one. Nah, nah. That's crazy. Here we go. Nah, 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 nah. Nah, 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 nah.
Hey, hey, hey. Goodbye.
Nah, nah, nah. All right, now we done sung it too. Last time, this is strike eight. This is it right here. Whatever you say, we're gonna flip it over. All right, you ready, Sheila? Tell me another way people say, no, just hell, just tell me another way you say mother, cuz.
Well, Steve, I would say mom, but the answer mom is already up there.
Right. Well, let's just flip that shit over.
Right.
Give me Laverne. Give me Christina. Point values are double. Top seven answers on the board. What wouldn't you do even for $1 million? Christina.
Have sex.
Have sex. Laverne. Pass the play.
We're gonna play, Steve.
They're gonna play. Tamara?
Tamara.
Tamara, yes. How you doing? What are you doing?
Good, how are you? I work in hotel sales. I recently graduated with my MBA, and I just got engaged.
Hey, hey, hey,
hey. Woo, woo. Hey, he liked it, and he put a ring on it.
Yeah, you got to. You got to have standards.
Right.
They got to do it. You can't just let the guy walk you down the beach forever.
No.
No, it's a
time
frame.
You got to do something to prove yourself.
We meet the woman of our dreams, and she requires a wedding day. Thus, the proposal, the ring, and the wedding. That's just how it works. All right, what wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
I'm gonna say eat an insect.
Good answer.
I wouldn't do that. People do it.
You wouldn't eat an insect for $1 million?
Oh, no.
Man, barbecue sauce. Grill, be sauteing them in a pan. You just put the salt, pepper. Eat an insect. Eat a bug. All right, Joe, let's go. What wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
Kill somebody.
Yeah, kill somebody. All right, Mike, what wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
Give a speech in front of a crowd. What? I mean, I might.
Every night. $1 million. And have you laughing every 8 to 12 seconds for 2 straight hours. $1 million. I'm your man. Call me. I'll give you a speech about any damn thing. Hell, I'll do your speech for you. Give a speech. Angela.
Hello.
What wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
I would have to say steal.
Good answer. Good answer. There you go.
I would never steal. All right, Christina, what wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
Be on a reality show.
Yeah. Be on a reality show. All right, we got to be careful, darling. You got two strikes. Stokely family could steal.
I'm going to say skydive.
Nice.
Oh, really great hype.
Yep, can't do that. I agree. Skydiving. All right, Stokely family, what wouldn't you do even for $1 million?
Eat feces.
Okay.
Eat feces.
Number six.
Nothing.
Five.
Five.
What? Four.
Jump off.
All right, everybody, we got top six answers are on the board. Besides the bed, name some place people like to make love. Janice?
The car.
Car?
Oh, yeah, well,
you got it. All right,
it works.
Now. In the car!
We got to play.
They're going to play, okay. Dolores. Woo! Woo! Cannot know how happy I am right now. Rod, sides of bed, name someplace people like to make love.
On the couch!
You heard him, didn't you? You heard that, didn't you? Okay. On the couch! Jill, you're married to Rod.
I am, 14 years.
Ain't nothing quiet at y'all's
house. Ain't nothing quiet at our house.
Well, Jill, this is gonna be fun. Besides the bed, name someplace people like to make love.
I'm gonna say in the shower.
In the shower. Rod, big dog.
Woo!
Big dog.
Let the big dog eat.
Yeah.
Woo!
Right after you belly up. In the shower. Lori, you're pregnant. Besides the bed.
The kitchen table.
Wow.
Woo! Yeah, baby. Yeah. Woo! I'm hungry.
I gotta go to this church.
Woo!
I gotta go to this church. All right. The pregnant lady says the kitchen table's where it jumps off. Chef?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, cookie man. Yeah, got them cookies in your ears.
Can't on the floor.
Yeah. On the floor. One answer left, Spiegel family pastors. You don't even have a strike.
How about outside?
More specific.
On a blanket, outside. Okay.
What do you mean by outside?
Okay. In the park.
Woo! My girl right here ain't playing with you.
Outside on the blanket in the park.
Ladies, here we go. We got the top six answers on the board. We asked 100 women, name something that's more satisfying than a man. Ramsey.
Chocolate.
Wow.
We're gonna play.
These are the Fertile Girls. Taffy and Ramsey has young children. Their youngest baby is 7 months old. Tawny, Heidi, and Mackenzie right now are currently expecting. And where y'all from?
Eager, Arizona.
So out in Eager, we know what's happening. You ain't heard of Eager, so that means it probably ain't a lot to do around town, but the Finch girls done figured it out. Tawny?
You got it.
Hi, darling. How you doing?
Good. How are you?
Tell everybody, what do you do again?
I am a domestic goddess.
A domestic goddess. Like that right there. That's a good thing there, Tawny. Tawny, we talked to 100 women. Name something that's more satisfying than a man.
What about a good movie? A chick flick.
A good movie. Hi, Heidi. How you doing?
Hello. I'm great.
You're a nurse, right?
I am.
Good, and pretty good player, too.
Working on it.
Okay, Heidi, we asked 100 women name something that's more satisfying than a man.
We love shopping.
Shopping. Yeah. Mackenzie, hi, darling.
Hi, how are you?
All right, we talked to 100 women. Name something that's more satisfying than a man.
I'm going to say sleeping.
Sleeping. Taffy, we got two strikes. You got to be careful. The Brewer family can steal.
A massage.
A massage. All right, Brewer family, here we go. You had plenty of time. What are y'all doing? Hey, what's wrong with y'all? The whole time I've been talking with the ladies, you've been in the huddle. You can't, once we come out the huddle, we need one of these hands. Y'all just hollering. Big Robert, we got this, we got this. Come on now, 20,000, we got to get this. All right, Derek, here we go. Here's your chance. We talked to 100 women. Name something that's more satisfying than a man.
Sexual toy.
Woo! Sexual. Hey, Big Robert, was that your answer? Yeah. Say it! Say it! We gotta get this 20,000! Sexual toy! Number six. Five.
Success.
Two. Bill, only one strike. Talk to 100 women. Name something the Pillsbury Doughboy and your man have in common.
He's white.
Oh, man, that's funny to me. Man, that's the best answer I done heard. I love real answers, man. Well, I can't think nothing else, Steve. I'm looking at him, I'm looking at me. Hell, both of us is white. I'm gonna go with he's white.
Come on, come on, come on.